Okay, howdy, howdy, guys. Welcome back to another sesh. We're down here at Silverbacks, as usual. Going to be training some arms today. We're in for an earlier session than usual because I've got to head down to the city, head down to Melbs for some business. So, ultimately, keep it up. Okay. Had Teddy here in the background doing a cheeky bit of dancing. Anyway. So going to be training arms, get it done and dusted for today. Hopefully the energy is picking up pace because usually it peaks a little bit later, but you know, we had some pre-workout, we should be good. Going to do some, we'll see what's free. It's a different time of the day, so I'm not really sure what's free and how busy it is compared to what it's usually like in the arvos. I think we're just going to have to take this one as it goes, but Yeah, we'll see how we go. Anyway, let's get stuck in. Okay, let's get stuck on in, guys. Just did a quick warm up with a 5 kilo dumbbell, just on some really controlled. I like to actually put my body into leverage points that really demand contraction when I'm doing light warm up stuff. So with the dumbbell, for example, actually I won't do it with this one, just it'll affect my working set. But I kind of pull it out that way because there's gonna be a lot of stress on keeping the top of the actual origin of the bicep steady because it connects to the shoulder, but then also insertion at the bottom. So origin and insertion, the origin being closest part to the center of the body, and the insertion being the furthest part away, or the distal part, I guess you'd call it. So then when I squeeze that there and holding it out here, really turns the biceps on. I don't do it in all the sets as it can be a little bit too stressful for certain parts of my body when going really heavy. That's where I just try to solidify and get the elbow moving, more or less. But we try to do it where we can if we want to really drive a bit more contraction through that bicep. Okay, so we're going to start with biceps, then go into our dumbbell skull crushers. Let's go. Move up after this, but let's smash out these dumbbell skull crushers first. Nice and easy. Let's move up. Let's move up a bit faster. We need to start moving into some real solid working set weight. So let's move up to 17.5 on each side, and we'll go from there. Let's do it. So I switched over to the Tamron zoom lens. I'm pretty sure I'm centered into the screen now. Yeah, I find this a bit of a better shot. It gives people a bit more privacy behind me instead of using a wide angle and kind of just like shotgunning it in front of me here, especially when I go down into the hammer curl. So this way I can kind of just zone in on myself through the mirror. I think I'll use this shot a bit more often for anything down near the dumbbell rack, as the tripod stays pretty close to my bench and it stays out of people's way. And, you know, that's one of the things, guys, is that me doing this is not meant to be a problem for other people, so I've got to try and minimize that. Either way, let's get into the second set, which is a lot more of a working set. Smashing out the dumbbell curls into the skull crushers. Let's do it. That was good. Now, it's just something I was thinking about just then was that your working set doesn't really start until it feels like shit, and that's when it begins. Once that starts to happen, you gotta just keep pushing through until you feel like you're about to fail. Okay, and I still had a few in the tank, so we'll definitely go up to either 20 or 22.5 after this and bust out at least 10 to 12 on each arm. Okay, skull crushers. Thank you.
Oh, nice.
Oh. Got some catapult action with the hat there. Not bad.
Okay.
Not too shabby. Elbow joints aren't liking that too much, but that's all right. Could be the fact that I'm training way earlier than I'm used to, and my body's still just trying to wake up slash warm up. See how we go. Okay. Yep. So I've got to at least go up to the 20s to try and maintain my strength. I don't really want to be getting too far behind with that. So let's move up to at least the 20s and we'll see how we go from there. Set number 3. I reckon we'll do 4 in total. I can't afford to be too long with this session because we are under a little bit of a time limit. But we'll see how we go. Should be all G to get everything done. Even if I do my second superset as something that just goes for a fair few more working sets like I usually do, that's probably going to be the way it has to go. Okay, let's get it done. 20 kilos now. Let's go dual arm so we can get it done a little quicker. I don't like where my left shoulder's sitting. Oh well. Good, I'm happy with that. Strength's not too bad. 15 at 20 is still a good number, especially when seated. Okay. This is the one that really matters though, guys, because my elbows are feeling this a little bit more than I'd like today. The skull crushes. But see how we go. It's just about positioning as well and making sure I get the correct mind muscle connection. Otherwise I draw it from the wrong spot, if that makes sense. Okay. Damn it, this hat needs to stay on more. Okay, that was pretty good. I was actually pretty happy with that. Like, that actually felt way better on my elbows than I thought it was gonna. The 17.5s actually hurt a little bit more than that, so that's really good to see. It's probably just needing to get my elbows warmed up. I think that was the main problem there. Okay, let's try finish strong and go the 22.5s. I'll be pretty happy with that. I don't want to really go too much heavier. I feel like I'm probably going to be putting a bit too much strain on my joints if I do that. Maybe on a day where I'm feeling just that little bit more juicy, like on a day after a refeed day. Let's see how we go. Either way, one more set of this, and then we'll move over to hopefully some cables. Okay. Let's do it. 22.5. Let's get 15. Let's go. Only 12. Okay. Let's get 12 of this at least. One more at least. Okay. Note to self, when you do anything like that, set the tripod away. I was too busy worried about the tripod that actually took it a little away from my strength. Ah well, either way, we're done with all this. Let's move over to a cable. Yeah. We're starting on the seat supported or chest supported spider curls. I've been finding them amazing lately. And then doing our usual superset with the tricep pushdowns. So hopefully, you know, honestly, it's getting a bit busy now. I'm just gonna sit here and smash out just a good 5 working sets. We'll get it done, and then we're gonna go, if I can fit it in, because I've gotta leave for Melbourne very soon. That was way too light. That's all good. We'll go up by probably a good 4 plates. Let's do triceps. Okay. Let's do it. Again, too easy. Let's up everything. Everything. Okay, next set. We've upped it substantially, guys. This should be a good one, hopefully. Yeah, that's a lot heavier. Okay. Let's do it. Okay, ooh, that was good. That was much better. Okay, tricepies. Okay, this should be a hell of a lot more of a working set. I upped it by about double, so this should be a lot better. Okay, let's get 12, no, 12. Let's get 15, okay. Easy. Let's go full stack after this for sure. Okay, we upped it only a tiny bit. We didn't want to go too crazy. So with this, we've got to get at least 12 good ones. Let's see how we go. Okay. Okay. Oh, fuck. Yeah, that was rough. Okay, triceps. Okay. I don't know what set this is, but let's just keep doing it. Actually, I did say I was going to do full stack, so let's go. Full stack. Nice, I felt great. Sweet. Okay, we'll try one or two more sets. I'm running out of time, so we need to leave within half an hour. I've got plenty of time. I'll try and aim for two. Okay. Whew. Oh man, I'm getting freaking tired, hey, but gotta do it. One more set of each and we're done. So I decided for the last one, I'm gonna drop the weight and just go for an AMRAP, as many reps as I can. As many reps as possible is the technical term. Now here we go. That's that done. Just triceps now. Okay, here we go. Now, I actually lowered the weight significantly so we can focus on an AMRAP of this one as well. One more. Ah. Okay. That's it. Okay. That's arm day. That's arm day done and dusted. I've got to go. It's 12:30. I need to be home by 1 so we can leave for Melbourne for an appointment at like 3, 3:30, something like that. So I am cutting it a bit fine, but there should be a bit of variance there just in case traffic's a bit hectic. Either way, that wasn't a bad session at all. I definitely could tell my body doesn't like not training when I'm used to training. It's obviously gotten used to it. Circadian rhythm slash biological clock, if you want to call it that, has obviously set a timer in my body to give me a bit more oomph later on in the day, which is normal. That's what happens. We adapt to situations and all that kind of stuff. So ultimately, that's done and dusted. I have a rest day tomorrow. It's my remedial day. And then after that, it's leg day. But got to do it. And my legs, I tell you what, I'm getting pissed off with them because they're not growing the way I'd like them to. Either way, it is what it is. It's all a part of it. Either way, thanks for watching. And you guys stay swole, shredded, sweaty, strong, super saiyan, and sexy. And a whole other list of S words. Most of all, stay tuned. And remember to squeeze the juice. Okay, see you guys.